Hello, today we are going to look at a simple explanation of Juniper's class of service. You may know this as quality of service with other vendors, or QoS, but Juniper like to call it class of service, COS. Don't confuse this with class of service as part of the Ethernet format. We're going to look at how it works today in this video, and in another video, we'll see how it's configured. Let's start with queues. A queue is a small amount of memory where packets are stored until they can be processed. When a packet arrives, they will sit in the ingress queue until it can be processed. A packet will be put in the egress queue before it is sent out, and there are several queues per interface. Most Juniper devices have either 8 or 12 hardware queues per interface. We can give each of these queues a different priority, and that's how COS prioritizes traffic, by servicing each queue according to how important it is. In Junos, we configure this through forwarding classes. This creates a name for each queue. We can create as many as we want up to the limit of the platform. As I said before, usually 8 or 12. There are 4 forwarding classes predefined in Junos by default, and we can use those if we want to, or we can create our own. Now, classifiers. How does the router decide which packet goes into each queue? Well, that's what the classifier does. The router will look at each packet and classify it based on some condition. Junos supports 3 types of classifier. There's fixed, the behaviour aggregate, and multi-field. Fixed classifiers are very basic. With these, all packets that arrive on a particular interface are placed in some specific queue. Behaviour aggregate, or BA classifiers, look at markings within the packet headers. So these will be DSCP markings, IP precedence, layer 2, COS, MPLS, EXP bits, those sorts of things. And it will assign the packet to the queue based on those markings. That's a very fast classifier, but it relies on the packets to be marked first. The multi-field classifier, or MF classifier, looks at other packet details. That includes things like the source and destination IP address, the ports, the protocol types, that sort of thing. We implement that in Junos using a firewall filter. This is slower to process each packet, but it doesn't rely on the packets being marked first. To send a packet, it needs to be taken out of a queue and put onto the physical medium. So a copper cable or a fiber optic cable or Wi-Fi radio signals or whatever it might be. And only one packet can be put onto the medium at one time. So the scheduler is the component that decides which packet is put onto the wire next. We can use this to tell the router how much time to spend on each queue, and that's how we can prioritize some packets over others. This is also where we assign bandwidth to queues. It includes allocating buffer memory to each queue, the priority, such as low latency queues for voice and video, and RED, or random early detection, which in Junos is called a drop profile. Once each scheduler is defined, we can then map it to a queue with a scheduler map. So that's the very brief, quick intro into how class of service works in Junos or on Juniper switches and routers. So I'm now going to create a video on how to configure the things we've just looked at, and I hope to see you there.